anthems, followed by an invocation given by Chaplain David Lyle.
Group, attention, halt! Present, halt! Order, halt! Parade, halt!
Our text for today's Festa della Liberazione event comes from the Hebrew Scriptures, Exodus chapter 13, verse 3. Let us remember again the true source of liberation. Moses said to the people, "Remember this day in which you went out of Egypt, out of the house of bondage, for by the strength of the Lord's hand, you were brought out of this place." Secondo la lettura biblica, troviamo in Esodo 13:3 la parola di Dio. Mosè disse al popolo, "Ricordati di questo giorno, nel quale siete usciti dall'Egitto, dalla condizione servile, perché con mano potente il Signore vi ha fatto uscire di là. La pace del Signore sia con voi, preghiamo." Let us bow our heads in prayer. Lord, as we come before you with gratitude for your protection and your guidance through these tough times for this great country, we ask humbly only two things. We ask that you empower us to remember the sacrifices made to free Italy from the scourge of fascist rule and wicked Nazi influence 75 years ago. We also plead again for your hand of age-old guidance and deliverance to free this land, our land, and in your creation of another scourge, albeit silent, but no less deadly. Signore, oggi preghiamo umilmente per due cose. Primo, ringraziamo per la nostra liberazione 75 anni fa. Riconosciamo la tua bontà e il loro sacrificio. Aiutanos a non dimenticare adesso e per sempre. Anche Signore della vita e della morte, della malattia e della salute, ti imploriamo per tuo aiuti contro un nemico silente, persistente e letale. Liberaci dalle mani del nostro nemico oggi. Now bless this event of remembrance. We ask all these things, Lord, in the name that we each pray and believe. In nome del Padre, il Figlio, e del Spirito Santo. Amen.
I would like to introduce our co-host, Colonel Biasutti, the senior Italian officer, for his remarks.
Sir, gentlemen, good afternoon. Thank you for taking this opportunity to pay respect for those this ceremony remembers. Today we recall an important era, the end of one of the cruelest conflicts in Italian history and the new beginning for the Italian people. Their struggle is summarized in one word, liberazione, liberation. Today is the Liberation Day in Italy. That word has different meanings for many in Italy. It represents heroic acts conducted by different Italians, unknown individuals, famous leaders, military forces, irregular groups of fighters. They had all their own objectives, but all of them were motivated by the need to end the suffering of the Italian court in a cruel war. There were many of the Italian armed forces who, after the armistice on September 8, 1943, joined the fight against the Nazi and fascists alongside the Allies. Their fight was both behind the enemy lines and on the front lines across the Italian peninsula. They contributed to the final victory of the Allies on the Italian front. I offer you just a couple of examples. There was Second Lieutenant Renato Del Din, an Alpini officer, who formed a group of irregular soldiers in Friuli and died during an attack against the enemy on this day in 1944. Our Del Din Army installation here in Vicenza is dedicated to his bravery and memory. Another fighting unit important to me was the Goito Bersaglieri Battalion, which was part of the Corpo Italiano di Liberazione that fought on the front lines alongside the Commonwealth forces. Together, they fought their way in and recaptured Bologna on 21st of April 1945. Only some days later, through another direction, US forces liberated Vicenza. Then there are the many unknown soldiers who refused to join the Nazi and fascists and were interned in the concentration camps in Germany and Poland. Many never returned home. To these patriots and their comrades, we owe our respectful thoughts and prayers, knowing their choice was not as easy as we might think today. Their courage and valor sowed the roots for the new armed forces of the Italian Republic, who became part of the NATO force some years later to defend against another threat to our freedoms. Today reminds us the liberation from dictatorship and from one of the worst ideological nightmares of the 20th century. Many Italians consider the date as the end of the World War II and as the beginning of a new course of freedom for the Italian people. 1 year after the war, in 1946, the Italian people chose a republican form of government and voted for a new constitution, giving for the first time rights to women. Today, join me in giving thanks to those heroes. Side by side, Americans and Italians, we remember their sacrifices. We remember those who fought before us, who overcame pain and adversity, and made a lasting contribution to the building of a free world where people can enjoy shared values of freedom and democracy. Viva le Forze Armate degli Stati Uniti d'America, viva le Forze Armate Italiane. Thank you.
Thank you, Colonel Biasutti. At this time, I'd like to introduce Colonel Daniel Vogel, Commander, United States Army Garrison, Italy, for his remarks.
Buongiorno. The United States and Great Britain joined the fight to liberate Italy with the invasion of Sicily in July of 1943. It took four major offenses in the early part of 1944 before the Allied forces could capture Rome. It was in battle where the American and Italian partnership was forged. One example is the story of Giuliano Ciapponi, who died last October and was laid to rest in Livorno's Lupi Cemetery. As a teenager, he was walking to his home in the surrounding hills of Livorno when he saw a damaged American warplane losing control. Just before it had crashed, a parachute appeared. And having grown up in the area, he was very familiar with the surrounding woods and went out to rescue the pilot. He found the pilot and managed to transport him home to his family's house. For the next 42 days, the family provided comfort and aid to the pilot. With the help of a nurse, his burned arms and legs were treated. When Allied troops reached the area, Giuliano escorted the pilot to a fellow American soldiers. In a media interview years later, when Giuliano was asked why he would risk his own life and that of his family for that of an American soldier, he simply answered, "It was my duty." There are many other stories similar to Giuliano's that we should pause and reflect upon today that demonstrate the friendship and combined effort of the Italian and the U.S. military. Thank you.
Please welcome our host for today's ceremony, Major General Roger Cloutier, Commanding General, United States Army Africa, Southern European Task Force, for remarks.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for being here. I'm Major General Roger Cloutier, the commander of U.S. Army Africa Southern European Task Force. I want to thank Colonel Biasutti and Colonel Vogel for their remarks, as well as Chaplain Lyle for the invocation. That was a powerful story Colonel Vogel just shared about Giuliano Ciapponi and the American aviator he risked his life to save. They're just two examples of the heroic and brave acts that personify the World War II generation. We continue to be inspired by them even 75 years later. The liberation of Italy, which we remember today, was achieved only after a long-fought struggle that began in the island of Sicily in 1943 and ended right here in northern Italy in April of 1945. Tens of thousands of Allied service members, supported by many Italians, died in the fight for liberation. We remember their ultimate sacrifice today. During that long two-year struggle, a unique bond of friendship formed between the United States and Italy. And over the preceding decades, it has only gotten stronger. Italy is a trusted and relied upon partner that has been at our side in the shared pursuit of a more peaceful and secure world. As commander of U.S. Army Africa Southern European Task Force, I lead an organization that has roots in Italy going all the way back to October of 1955. For nearly 65 years, the United States Army has had a home here in northern Italy. We are your neighbor, your friend, and your ally. As we stood together during the final years of World War II, we now stand together to stop the spread of COVID-19. As we experience victory in the spring of 1945, I know that we will get through this in the same way, together. Over the past few months, we have all taken extraordinary action to help save lives and stop the spread of the virus. I have always been proud of the strong Italian-American friendship and partnership that unites our two nations. But our unified response against COVID-19 has deepened my respect and appreciation for this bond that unites us. So today, we remember the dedication and sacrifice of those who fought for liberation during World War II, and we remember that we carry on their fighting spirit in the fight against COVID-19. There's still a long road of recovery ahead of us, but I know that we will get through this together. I am optimistic, and I believe this strongly. Andra, tutto bene. Grazie mille.
Please direct your attention to the memorial wreath. Major General Cloutier and Colonels Biasutti and Vogel are each going to lay a white rose at the base of the wreath, marking the significance of the 75th anniversary of the Festa della Liberazione. The wreath is inscribed with the words together and insieme and the dates of 1955 to 2020. The year of 1955 signifies the formal activation of the Southern European Task Force, locally known as SETAF. For nearly 65 years, Americans have been fortunate to call Vicenza and the surrounding communities home, and have been privileged to work alongside our strong, resilient Italian allies. Please prepare to render honors during the playing of taps.
Group attention, present, hold.
As you go about your day, please keep both Italian and American service members, past and present, in your thoughts and prayers. This concludes today's ceremony. Thank you for your attendance.